show me what I can do with my left hand.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's what she's saying. You're like, hey, I did. We'll go, no, it's okay. But what we're also going to say is, we don't expect you to be as good with your right hand. Okay? All right. Breath her off. That was well done right there. Again, she was dropping in, but we didn't make a big, huge correction about it. We just lifted and pressed, and we made the punishment fit the crime. She's dropping in, so we're going to lift her hand. Just breath her off. We're going to just keep your body in a forward-seat position. And again, if we're just going in a circle, what do I care if it takes you from here to here to get her out? It doesn't have to be now. It just has to be eventually. Fine. Nicely done. Nicely done. Now, keep your hands up. Keep your head up and look one quarter of a circle from where you are right now. Don't look down. I tell you all of this. The head's not going to fall off. If the head falls off, I'll buy you another.
Tell
people all this, and it's not as good an analogy as it used to be, but back when Tiger Woods was the greatest golfer the world has ever known, he had a coach. He had a coach then. And to keep him at that level of where he was. Everybody, I go get help all the time, and you said, can I come Saturday? No, I'm out getting help.
Okay, right.
You know? Ooh, there's that. Ooh, she took two steps, that running wall right there. And that's all about the body position and that leg pressure. And then balancing her and giving her some balance on the bit. That's what that's all about. That's why it's going to be a piece of cake. Piece of cake with her. God gave her this ability. This
thing. Right, right.
And I'm not going to be arrogant enough to say I'm taking credit here. God did this. You know?
Yeah, just the
bad. Good and bad.
I just want to cue it.
There you go. And ride it, because that running walk, when you're on a trail, especially when you're by yourself or something, how cool is it? And I'm going to teach you this for years and years. I'm going to teach you how to ride your horse, where if you're riding with some fat little short quarter horses that walk like this, I'm going to be able to teach you your body position where your mare will go right there with them.
Seriously?
And ride with them. And then if you're riding with some gated people that are riding box trotters or and then they want to walk on and get on, your body position will change ever so slightly, and then you're just right there with them. And that's what a lot of people have a hard time with, is that they can't trail ride with their friends because either their horse walks too fast or walks too slow, and it's a challenge. Somebody's either jogging and jigging or somebody's falling behind. We can't control that with our bodies. And there's no reason why we can't. We can slow her legs down, and I've done it so many times that I can prove it to you, that we can do this, so that you can trail ride with whomever you want based on what you're doing with your body.
Right. Yeah, she has an insane trot. I cannot get control of
her. Well, the biggest problem with that is that she doesn't have a developed top line yet, and we haven't learned how to drive her into the bit. You're packing her right now. She's not packing you. As we ride and we get more control through your body position and your cues, we will then develop a top line. Her back will lift. Her front end will lift. She'll drive from behind, and all of a sudden, that out-of-control trot will turn into something very, very, very animated and a lot of elevation. People go, well, how do I know? I go, it's kind of like, it's like good art. You'll know it when you see it.
Right.
You'll know it when you feel it, and you'll feel it when you start to cue it correctly.
And she's old enough, Paul.
Oh, sure.